Now we have Match Game 74, production number 0280, and it's take one. Get ready to match the stars. Donald Ross. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Patty Deutsch. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
That's not a microphone, that's a Crayola.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. And thank you, dear friends and gentle hearts, for joining us here on this day. You're going to have a peachy time because the loony bin is out again.
Hello there, friends.
Oh, listen, Fanny, I think you ought to stand up and show and tell.
Yeah. I wanted to explain to people this was Brett before she married. A lot of people don't realize she was a beauty. Oh.
She was a... That is something, isn't it?
Oh,
we're going to put you back on the bus.
Thank you.
Yeah. The sweater's nice, too. There. Yes?
Brett has broken one of her trainer wheels.
Something busted back there? Oh, yes, I see that. Well, see, we're just going to have to struggle along as best we can until the show's over.
She'll never know.
No, she'll never know. Let's say hello to our two players, Janet Finn and King Colvin here. How are you, Janet?
Fine.
Good. Janet is a current champ. She has $12,850. And she's happy about that. We're happy for her. And she's going to be challenged now by King Colvin, whom we are meeting for the first time and who we welcome most sincerely and warmly. King, would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I'm single, still looking for that queen. And I'm originally from Chicago.
See, his name is King. His name is King, you see. I'm single, still looking for the queen. You're not too quick, audience. They got it at home. Where were you then? All right, you're looking for your queen.
I'm originally from Chicago, now living in Los Angeles. I'm an electrician working for a major railroad.
Okay, good luck to you, King. We'll start this game right after we do a little business with America. That's going to happen right now. Shall we begin?
Shall we begin?
All right.
The beginning.
King Colvin.
I'd like to try B, please.
A, you want B?
B.
Oh, B, he said. Right. Did I hear a buzzing sound? No. Oh, geez.
No, you're just going crazy.
Okay, no, the chair is squeaking. I thought I heard a funny noise. Listen to this. While visiting Rome...
I heard it that time.
Do not upstage a star. You make one more funny noise, you got to go to your dressing room and stay there. Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
While visiting Rome, dumb Dora didn't have a coin, so she threw her blank into the fountain. While visiting Rome, dumb Dora didn't have a coin, so she threw her blank into the fountain. Three coins in the fountain.
Which one will the fountain blow?
Or sing Roses of Picardy.
Big hit on that song, no one remembers.
Yes.
Two people are ready.
Two roses are shining in Picardy, Fanny, for the folks.
Roses are shining in Picardy.
Oh, you made me misspell my word.
Okay, you're finished?
Yes.
Everybody else is finished, so we'll call on King Colvin over here to give us his response. While visiting Rome, dumb Dora didn't have a coin, so she threw her blank into the fountain.
Her husband.
Well, I don't know if you're going to find a queen that way, King. Donald, what do you say?
Three shorts in the fountain.
Dumb Dora?
She was dumb, wasn't she?
Donald!
She was dumb, wasn't she?
Well, I'll say she didn't smart enough to wear pants. She threw, she wore shorts. Well, anyway, Brett. Brett.
Oh, Patty, I just feel so sorry for her. I just get so sick. I can't help it.
What have you got there? He's says
he
husband.
You said he was a king looking for a queen?
Yeah.
I have someone in mind.
Show the answer.
Herself into the fountain, the poor little devil.
All right.
Dumb Dora didn't have a coin, so she threw a blank into the fountain in Rome. Enough of this hostility, children, Charles.
A very clever answer. Credit cards in
pretty good. Charles, that's very amusing. Have you thought of a career in show business or television or something?
No, but I'm thinking seriously of leaving this floor.
Patty Deutsch.
Yo.
Here it is. While visiting Rome, Dumb Dora didn't have a coin, so she threw her blanket in the fountain. He says husband.
I know. I said teeth.
Teeth? Why did you say teeth, Patty?
Magic and wishing, and there's the old tooth fairy that I don't want to get into a lot, but it does make sense to some of us.
Quiet, Der Kinder is listening up there. Oh, okay.
Kidding.
The tooth fairy is one of my best friends. Now be careful, Patty.
All right, Richard, let's hear it.
Hello, dear.
How are you, Gumdrop?
When I reveal my answer, you have to ask me why.
Okay.
Read the question first.
While visiting Rome, Dumb Dora didn't have a coin, so she threw her blank into the fountain.
Now, she threw her dress.
Really? Why?
Why?
Because it cost a pretty penny.
Okay. All right. Hi, now. King Colvin is looking for the answer, husband, Fanny.
I'm sorry, I don't work here.
This is not your table.
What?
Husband is his answer. What's yours? Dumb Dora did that threw a coin
in
the
front. I was in Italy and it's full of Italians. I said she threw her purse in.
Her purse.
Her whole purse.
Her whole purse.
I thought that was a good answer.
Okay. Well,
that's
King
terrible.
Colvin, he didn't do so well with that.
Credit cards.
They didn't do so well with it either. How about you, Janet Finn? Let's see what we've got for you. Brett said. Brett said. Will Rogers never met a man he didn't like, but Will Rogers never met blank. Brett said, Will Rogers never met a man he didn't like, but Will Rogers never met blank.
I have the perfect answer.
Sometimes I'm just so clever I can't stand myself.
She has won $12,850.
Honey, I have some land in South Alabama. It's a little damp, but if you would talk to me
none
after the show.
No, not allowed.
It's swampy, but it's sweet.
Putting down
Don. Cheese,
Gatorade. That's all. That's all. Finito. All right. Now, Janet Finn. Brett said, Will Rogers never met a man he didn't like, but Will Rogers never met
Jack Klugman.
Jack Klugman. Jack Klugman is what she said.
Who is Jack Klugman? Where is he now? Sylvia, who are you?
Your legally betrothed husband is Jack Klugman.
Oh, God love his little heart.
Donald, what do you say?
You'd think that after winning $12,850, Janet could get to read her own questions.
That's true.
And
yeah.
Give the answers.
Yeah.
I think we could all go home.
Right.
Well, I watch divorce court like everybody else in America, so I said Jack Klugman.
There you go.
There's one for you.
I guess your answer is not going to be a surprise, right?
Well, you know Janet and I have perfect rapport.
Oh, really? This has nothing to do with reality. This is just a little game you're playing.
Yes, and
in case you're watching,
said,
Jack.
Who was the dummy who said he never met a man he didn't like? I said Jack Klugman.
You said that, okay. That's your answer, Charles.
My husband.
Jack Klugman. Yes.
You don't know, Robbie.
Never met a man he didn't like, but Will Rogers never met, and she says Jack Klugman.
Yeah, well, see, I was trying to be tactful about the whole thing. So I said the Emmy-winning half of the Odd Couple TV show, which is why I...
Yeah, that's Jack why it took so long.
See, this way, I've also offended Tony Randall.
Yeah, because Tony Randall could take it personally, too,
right.
There. Richard?
President?
Yes. We're playing this game, you see.
Yeah.
She said Jack Klugman, and she's hoping you wrote Jack Klugman on your card.
Well, I also wanted to be discreet.
Oh.
I'm not a gossip, and I don't like to talk about rocky marriages. Well, I just put J. Klugman.
Oh, J. Klugman.
Okay. Don't let her hear.
I want to know.
The wife is always the last to know.
That's right. Her hearing aid is turned down. She can't hear.
What did he say?
Nothing. Nothing, dear. It's all right. All right, Fanny, it's your turn.
You said rocky, something like a boulder. Knowing Brett as well as I do, I had to say Jack Klugman.
There it is. So that's six for you. You got to work that out for you, King. Well, we're going to find out how King Colvin does in a moment or so, but first this, friends. Round one has been completed. At this moment, it's 6-0 in favor of our current champ, Janet Finn. We go to round two and point out to King that he must match every celebrity with this question to achieve a tie and stay in the game. You have your choice, sir.
B again, please.
B again. Let's see how he does with this. Everybody plays since no one matched in the first round. Susan and Richard were so skinny, they used to blank in the chimney. We're so skinny, they used to blank in the chimney. Charles is finished.
I hate it
tasteful.
When there are a lot of choices.
Tasteful. Very
tasteful. Susan and Richard. Hear that, King?
I did.
Okay. This is not an intellectual game, my dear. You're thinking too hard.
Huh?
I'm going back to Susanville, California next week.
All right.
Do they know that?
Here we go. King, Susan and Richard were so skinny, they used to blank in the chimney.
Dance in the chimney.
Dance in the chimney. Okay, King, you've got to match.
Dead. Long live the king.
Yes, sir. All right. Got to get six dancers here. My card is full, I'm sorry to say. Donald, what did you say?
I got him sleeping in the chimney.
Sleeping in the chimney. So, Jonathan wins another game. Yeah, dance. Smoke. Congratulations. Here's another $100 for you. Well, you got one dance I saw over there, maybe two. King, it's been a pleasure meeting you. We've got a gift for you together with our thanks for being with us.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye, King. Janet, you know how many, this is your seventh time up here? And you got 12,950, you're going to try for over 5,000 now. You ready?
Ready.
Okay, let's begin. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Zip blank.
Oh.
The answer they gave most often is worth $500, if you match it. And the next one is $250, and the third is $100. A little slow with the dinger there, weren't you, there? Okay, three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Richard.
Zipper.
Zipper. Okay,
yeah.
There's one.
That's an Charles. Open and shut case, folks.
Charles.
Zip code. Yeah.
Zip code.
Brett. How about zip gun?
Zip gun.
Yeah, that's like zipper.
Okay.
Well, group here who remembered Zip Gun.
No, with the crowd she hangs out, that's what they'd say, Zip Gun.
They say, who bought your Zip Gun?
Yeah, so she got Zip Gun, Zip Code, and Zipper. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Zip Code.
Good. Zip Code. Okay, that's Charles' answer. Let's see if it's up there, and if so, where? First, may we see the $100 response.
Gun, gun.
Zip Zap.
I like gun better than zap.
Zip Zap. Funny, it's little with
zap,
me.
Zap.
If you were here that day, would you have said zip zap?
Well, in all fairness to them, they would have said zap zip.
Zap.
Oh,
of course.
Zippity doo dah.
Thank you.
Zippity doo dah. Okay. Let's find out what's under. We're looking for zip code. Here is a $250 response. Zippity doo dah.
You just said that. Hey, I had that.
Zippity doo
dah.
It's an old song from a Walt Disney movie. All right, last chance for zip code. Here is a $500 response. Zip code.
congratulations. Hey, what'd you say?
Why, is my husband going to be nice to me?
Exactly, how nice is he going to be? Don't answer that question. All right, now listen, you got the $500 and you're going to play for 10 times that amount now. Remember, you have to match one celebrity head to head. Choose one now, please, Janet.
Charles.
Gonna go with Charles again.
She's okay. Gonna have cardiac
arrest. Well, Charles and she have been a winning combination before. Let's see how they do now. Ready? Here we go. Charles, write your answer to this, if you would, please. Russian blank. Russian blank. Russian blank. Okay. She's still doing her dance. Charles has finished his answer. Now, we need a response from you that you think will match Charles Nelson Reilly. Russian
roulette.
Charles, the enthusiasm from the audience leads me to believe if you don't say Russian roulette, you better leave town. Now, for $5,000, may we see your response?
We interrupt this program and give you news other than Watergate. The current champion on Match Game is $14,500. If this lady wins by turning over...
Just a minute.
By turning
now,
over...
Now, wait a minute. This is my show, Charles. What the heck are you doing? This is, I'm the MC.
If I turn my card over, this lady will win 18,450 and become the new champion if my card says roulette. $5,550, right. Then she and the 9 children will have to go quietly home.
Now, while we're all catching our breath here, we congratulate Janet Finn and we ask you to watch this message or two of interest.
But first...
Now, one thing I have to point out, while we appreciated Charles Nelson Reilly taking over the program as he did... There was a certain erratum which we have to correct.
Sometimes that happens in the news.
That's right. He said 14,500 had been the previous high winner. The previous high winner had been 15,000 even.
So Charles was wrong.
He was wrong. Right. Now, this lady is our new all-time high money winner. She has a total of $18,450. And perhaps you'd like to have your husband... share your joy and happiness. He's got a big smile on his face down there. Wayne, you got a shot of him? Mark, you got a shot of him? Okay. Yeah, there he is. Okay. Ladies, you got to quit here. We thank you very much. Silvana, well, we get your whole life story next time we get together, okay? Now, it's time for a little message of interest to one and all, so pay attention, folks. Well, our time is up here, and I'd like to thank all of you who have participated in the mayhem today.
That was really exciting.
Yeah, it really was.
I was really excited.
Yeah. About that land in Alabama.
Well, you know, she deserves it. She's a good contestant, and she's got so many good places to put the money, and that's
I was
really...
the hero.
That's right.
Or the heroine, as the case may be.
Next time we get together, we're gonna have these celebrities for you.
Charlie Brill. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly, George Bulafont, Richard Dawson, and Marsha Wallace.
Dean Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time.